Hello everyone, welcome to Veriscon 2020. Hope you all are safe and watching Veriscon from the comfort of your home. So today we will be talking about fake news 4, building a Veris AI application to combat the fake news. I'm Jayesh Bapu Ahive. I'm an AI researcher and consultant. I work around cloud and my current research interest is distributed neural computers. I like playing with Veris and Veris AI stuff. I have built some cool demos around Veris AI as well. Talking about fake news, what is fake news? According to Wikipedia, fake news, also known as a junk news, pseudo news or hoax news, is a form of a news consisting of deliberate disinformation or hoaxes spread via traditional news media, print and broadcast, or online social media. Why we need this kind of application? Fake news is a major issue in this digitally connected world. So when we talk about fake news as an issue, we might have noticed similar articles were flowing to the social media or news agencies in last 2-3 months. And is this a new issue? No. So this issue exists from a long time. Past back in World War I or World War II time, this issue was there. So fake news is a, but today this is a major concern, because today the fake news can impact millions of people, because everyone is connected to each other via internet and the social media. The impact of social media is really high, and especially when this type kind of news comes from the reputed news sources or reputed people, the impact increases. And when we talk about this context of impact, In India last year, some of the major riots and some of the major lynchings happened due to fake news spread via WhatsApp. So there's the third point. There's no easy to use solution available in the market to combat this issue. So people are working on the various techniques and technologies to combat the fake news and identify fake news or fake articles and resolve the issue. The companies like Google and Facebook itself are working on this. But there's no user-centric solution around this. So can we as a developer turn to machine learning and use it to solve this problem? So how we can use machine learning for fake news detection? So whenever it comes to machine learning, we know that there are two things we have to consider: feature extraction and model construction. Talking about features, there are some characteristics of any news article in general. First, content. So content can include text or claim the particular article contains. Second, source. The source can be author or publisher, and the reputation matters as well. Third one comes as a social aspect, or so the social media spread. So how the social engagement for that particular article works, like the spread of the article, the endorsements of the article, all those things we have to consider. So those things we can divide into two types: news content features and social content features. Talking about news content features, we can work around with some linguistic features which we can extract using NLP: vocabulary, phrase structure, writing style. This can also involve use of inflammatory language, or some patterns we can found, or some misleading headlines we can found, and this kind of features comes into news content features. The second type of a content features are social content features. This type of features include publisher's profile, user's opinion, friendship and diffusion's network. So when it comes to publisher's profile, the credibility of the publisher author matters the most. We can say if the given article is fake or not, or the given claim is wrong or not, based on the publisher's profile. Then again, the user's opinion, how the users are getting engaged with it, and what users or what people think about a particular claim matters the most. Then the friendship and diffusion networks, how the spread of the particular article happened via social media, this is also we can consider. Then we go to model construction. In model construction, again, we can build model in two different contexts. One is a news context model, and others are social context model. In news context model, we can build a fact-checking model, which will be a binary model, which will classify news as fake or not. It will be like it will be one or zero. So this fact checking model is a supervised type of model we can train using a label data. So this is one of the model we are building today. Second one is a clickbait detection. The clickbait detection is finding patterns for misleading headlines and detecting those. The third one is stance-based model. So stance-based model detection, stance-based fake news detection is one of the technique we are using, and this is the second type of model we will be building in this process. So this is a deep learning based technique to identify the fake news, and we will discuss it in details in coming slides. Second category is social context model. Social context model include tools or social bot detection and fake news propagation pattern detection. Going ahead, what are the requirements for this project? So we will require a Redis install with the Redis module. Then we will require a Twilio account, which you can go to the twilio.com or sign up using this link over here. And you will get some free credits, which will be enough for this project to run. Then a Twilio WhatsApp sandbox, which we can configure using Twilio console. Then we have to set up a basic Python and class developer environment. Talking about data set. So for the first model we are building, it is supervised model, as I said, which is a binary classifier, tells if the news is the fake or not. For this, we will need some data set, right? A label data set. We are using LIAR data set over here by William Yang Wang. LIAR data set has 14 columns with different types of features. But for the sake of simplicity, we have converted this data set into two different columns only. Data set with two different columns. So column one contains statement, it is news, headline or text, and column two contains label for the particular headline, article or text. So this modified data set we'll be using for generating one of the model. The second technique we are using is a stance-based fake news detection pipeline. What happens in stance-based fake news detection pipeline is, suppose we have some claim or some article roaming around on social media, or we have a link for that article. So we just feed those things to our model. The first thing is when we have that claim, we will extract the keywords from it, and then we will provide it to some search engine. The search engine can search for the keywords or for that particular claim through a local database, otherwise a web, and find all the matching articles. Now we have all the matching articles, and according to the publisher's profile and according to the user's opinion and user's engagement, we will have the credibility score for each of the news source or each of the article. And according to that credibility, we will assign weights to each of these articles. So now we have set up the articles which match our claim with weights which are defined by the credibility. Now when we provide this as an input to the stance detection neural network, it will give us an output like if the particular article agrees, disagrees or neutral on the particular claim. So here we can observe that for the when we provide a particular keyword and it has searched for the article, it provided 5 results with arranged with the credibility and assigned weights we provided to the stance detection NLP. And now we have 2 of the higher credibility article disagreeing with the fact. One of them is a neutral, then one lower credibility article agrees with the fact and one disagrees. So what we can do is we can do weighted sum for all of the outputs, and on base of the weighted sum we can decide if the given article is a fake or not. In this case, it's fake. So how our end application will look? This is how our end application should look like. So we will have a WhatsApp based chatbot or a messaging any messaging application based chatbot where you enter a claim, highlight any headline or news articles link, and in return you will get output like the news headline is true or false, or and corresponding probability of it being true or false. So now we know like what the problem we want to solve and what thing we are building. But why we need Redis AI for this? So many people will say that this is what we can build using number of solutions available, and this is what we can deploy using number of production level solutions available. So why Redis AI for this? So talking about production level deployment, as most people say, AI, you are not building AI application until you are productionalizing it, right? So what are the production strategies I can consider? The first one is writing a Flask or Django based wrapper for my Python code and deploying it. But this thing is not scalable. So if I want a scalable application, I have to think of different solutions. Then the second thing comes in mind is I can use any cloud provider services. I can use Amazon SageMaker. I can use Google Cloud's AI platform to deploy my application and use it. So this is one of the things which I can consider, and this is scalable as well. Third thing, runtime. So I can use a TensorFlow serving runtime or Berkeley Clipper or NVIDIA TensorRT, MXNet model server, and I can get things working. Otherwise, I can write a C++ runtime for myself and create a bespoke solution. And if I want to scale it, I will use Kubernetes. So this all things I can do for if I want to think of getting my model into production. But there are some production requirements I have. The production strategy I'm choosing must fit the technology stack I have. So suppose I'm storing my data into S3 and I have the whole thing built around Amazon Web Services or AWS, then I should choose Amazon SageMaker probably. So the fitting to technology stack matters the most, and it reduces the complexity. Then it's not just about languages, but about semantics, scalability, and guarantees. It should run anywhere on any size of data. It should be composable with the building blocks. So even one of the things fail, the whole thing should be the other thing should be replaced, and we can work around the composable building blocks. We must try to limit the amount of the moving parts and the amount of the moving data. So to reduce the complexity and to increase the efficiency as well as speed of the processing, we should limit the moving parts. So if the data and model should be in a close vicinity, or if you go like this, should be stored in the same place to increase the efficiency. And we must make best use of the resources. So these all things should be satisfied to be my ideal production level deployment. So what is Redis AI? Redis AI is a machine learning or deep learning model serving solution. It's a Redis model providing tensors as a data type, deep learning model execution on CPUs as well as GPUs, and it provides a script, a subset of the Python language, which runs on a C++ runtime for tensor operations. It turns a Redis into a fully fledged deep learning runtime while still being Redis. So this is a very robust solution we have. So now, what Redis AI actually is? There's a Redis AI at the center. We have a Redis database, and we have tensors data type around it. And now, for the backend, we have different kind of solutions. This is a very important feature Redis AI provides. We have different types of backends available at the same time. We have PyTorch, we have TensorFlow, we have ONNX, and we have TensorFlow Lite. So even suppose in my pipeline I have a TensorFlow model, and I'm using TensorFlow serving to deploy it. Now I got some PyTorch model coming in, and I want to introduce that in my pipeline. So I have to change my TensorFlow serving, and I have to use some different production deployment solution to introduce my PyTorch model. But if you are using Redis AI, it's pretty simple. You can just use the Redis AI has readily available PyTorch backend, which you can utilize for this. So this thing simplifies the whole scenario here. Again, introduction of the TorScript. Script. We will discuss about TorScript in details in the coming slides as well. But as I said earlier, it's a subset of the Python language which runs on a very efficient C++ interpreter. So it reduces the execution time. We can run the code on the CPU, GPU, CPU as well as GPU, and there's a default replica as a feature available. So how the architecture of the Redis AI works? When we talk about the architecture, there's a queue available. So even if you have hundreds of requests coming in, you can queue those all requests, and where the thread pulls the model as well as there's an extra thread which pulls the model as well as tensors, and it runs the whole thing or executes the whole thing in the separate block and gives you the output. So where we can from where we can get the Redis AI. So the easiest thing you can do is you can do Docker win and you can get Redis AI running. Otherwise, if you want to deploy it in production, then you can go to this github.com/redis AI and download the whole thing. Or there are some instructions to install the Redis AI on your platform. So how we can operate the Redis AI? So if you have a Redis server installed and you downloaded the Redis module, then now you can just do Redis server /load module, and you can load the Redis AI.so file, that is Redis AI module, into it. Talking about tensors, so as I said, the tensors is a highlighting point over here. So tensor is a new data type which got introduced with Redis AI, and there are some of the functionalities which come with the tensor. So we can do ai.tensor set, set a tensor, and we can do ai.tensor get to get the value of the tensor in a tensor back. So when we do tensor set for the particular value, like as we know, Redis is a key value store database. So when we do ai.tensor set foo is a key over here with a data type float, 2x2 is a shape and values are 1, 2, 3, 4. So the foo value will be set to the foo key will be set to the tensor of the value 1, 2, 3, 4. Now if you have large number of data to set into a tensor, then you can use a byte array and you can set those values. You can do ai.tensor get the name of the tensor and type of the tensor to get the value of the tensor back. Talking about tensors, as I said, tensor is a very important part when it comes to the whole Redis AI thing. This is the part which makes it robust and makes it efficient. So this tensor is based on DLPAC. So now you can see over here, this is a C structure for the tensor, and this whole thing is framework independent. You don't need to change data, you just need to change this DL context to shift from one framework to another framework. So suppose I want to change my model from PyTorch to TensorFlow, then I just need to change the DL context. So suppose I want to have two or three different kinds of models in my pipeline, or suppose I'm building my pipeline with a PyTorch model as well as TensorFlow model. So when I'm getting output from the TensorFlow model, I can just convert it to PyTorch tensor and feed it to PyTorch model. So this increases the robustness and helps us to deploy two or three different types of models based on different type of frameworks into a single pipeline. So how we can work with the models in Redis AI? We can do ai.modelset. So ai.modelset, how it works, you can do ai.modelset ResNet 18, which is your key, the backend you are using, like the key for the backend, and then you want to use CPU or GPU and your model. So this is how you can set model. In case of a TensorFlow, it's a bit different because, as you know, for the sessions, TensorFlow user also takes the input for inputs and outputs. So in case of a TensorFlow, it's a bit different, and so the same as PyTorch for again Onyx. So you can do ai.modelset key Onyx, that is backend name, your CPU, GPU, whatever you're using, and your model file. So then how you can run a model? To run any model you have set on a TensorFlow, you set on a Redis AI, you can do ai.modelwin, your model name, provide your inputs and output key, and you're done. Again, coming back to TOS script, as I said, it was one of the features I highlighted in earlier slide. So how TOS script work, or where we can use TOS script? So suppose you are building a pipeline for any particular application. Consider the application you are building, the fake news flow. So when I get a liar data set, there are some pre-processing and feature extraction part involved, right? So I'm writing a Python code for it. That part will be done. Then comes a model building, and then comes the inference. So this is a pipeline I'm following. Now I'm just So for time being, like for now, when I create model using the model, like when I create model, and after that I will deploy that model to Redis AI, and I'm just doing inferencing part using the Redis AI thing right now. But if I want to do the pre-processing part or some feature extraction part on GPU, so this is possible using TOR script. What I can do is I can write a TOR script, which is a Python code, and I can set the script using ai.scriptset, and provide like the device I want to execute this thing on, CPU or GPU, and then add the file, and I can run that file on the GPU. So what is TOR script? Scripts are the TOR script interpreter. Script is a TOR script interpreter which we are using for Redis AI. It's a Python-like syntax for TensorOps. It can run on a CPU as well as GPU. It has vast library of tensor operations. It allows to prescribe computations directly without exporting from a Python environment. So it allows you to pre-processing, post-processing, but it's not only restricted to that. It has a wide variety of use cases around this. So when you have an input, so suppose I want to build this whole pre-processing, post-processing and the model inferencing pipeline. So now I have an input key, I will provide it to the TOR script, which is a pre-processing. I have written a script for the pre-processing. Then there's a model which I'm using for inferencing, and then post-processing and output. So this is how we can simplify the whole thing using TOR script. One of the important feature again Redis AI provides you is a replication. So master replica is supported for all data types, and so even if Sentinel you're deploying on is bricks, then also you can go ahead and use the then also the Redis AI provides this fault tolerance. Any of the slave master master slave architecture, any of the slave will be promoted to master, and it can continue from the stage or state the earlier node failed or earlier master failed. So this is very efficient and this is very helpful. The replication is very helpful in most of the cases. So this is a chatbot built in Redis AI example. So you can go to the Redis AI examples repo and you can find the chatbot application. So this shows how Redis AI, Redis replication in general helps when it comes to this whole fault tolerance thing. So suppose I have an encoder decoder for my chatbot. So whenever the new message comes in, so this conversation is going on, and now the current state is saved over here, and this current state is replicated to all the other slaves. Now if my master fails, the another slave will be promoted to the master, and now this different node is a master, and this can continue the conversation from the existing level or existing state of interaction. So this makes the thing very robust. So availability of the Redis AI client libraries. Currently Redis AI client libraries are available in the Java and Redis and Python. Node.js and Go libraries are in building, and they will be available soon. Yeah, when it comes to ecosystem, the MLflow deployment plugins are available for the Redis AI, and Kubeflow integration is also under development. So this makes the whole solution very efficient and easy to use with the various platforms. So what are the advantages of the Redis AI in today's world? So we are getting ease of deployment. It's easy to deploy, as we have seen. It runs on multiple backends. It runs on a TensorFlow Lite, ONX, then PyTorch. It runs with the multiple devices. It keeps the data local. It provides you high performance. It has a complete ecosystem with the Kubeflow and MLflow types of solutions. It has seamless auto batching. It provides you the Sentinel and clustering structures. And as it has a replication tool, and which helps us to make it more robust. It is language independent, and it runs anywhere where Redis runs. So you can go to this repository Redis AI examples, github.com/redisai/redisai example, and see many of the examples built in, and you can play around it and build your own examples around. So let's jump to a demo, like the application. So now we know what the problem we wanted to solve and why we use Redis AI to solve this problem. So let's see how our chatbot came up and how the solution looks like. So if you have your mobile phones, take them out and open WhatsApp. Just scan this QR code from the any QR code scanner and you will be redirected to a particular number. So when you are redirected, when you are in a chat with that particular number, just send a message join hidden-city. So when you do this, you will be entered in a sandbox. So when you are in the sandbox, just send any news headline, any claim, or any link to the news article of your choice to this particular number and see what you get in return. So you might have got something like I have shown you earlier, like the given news article is fake or not, and probability of it being fake or not fake. It's cool, right? So if you want to play around the code behind this whole application, or if you want to check how I built it, and if you want to build something around this, you can scan this QR code to go to the GitHub repository and clone it. If you want to discuss something around this, you can go to my Twitter handle. It's down there as well. You can go to my Twitter handle and DM me. We can surely talk about this. So if you want to explore more of a Redis AI, you can go to all those references, and there's a very detailed blog by my friend Shivin Thomas on the Medium. You can check this out, and this will surely help you understand Redis AI better. So thank you guys, and enjoy the Redis Conf.